Going. Okay. So, I'd like to welcome everyone here this Monday night for a holographic sound meditation and healing experience. Those of us that are here in person and those that are joining us online. So anyhow, welcome. You know, a lot of times it's kind of nice when this falls on a full moon or a new moon, you know, and it gives kind of a theme to the experience. But we're right in the middle of everything now, and which is just fine because meditation is meditation. It doesn't really matter when we do it and whether we really have a theme or not. So anyway, I invite you, if you haven't set intentions, that you do, and if you'd like to write them down, this is traditionally what we do if you're here, if you haven't been here before. Writing them down just simply and placing them in the bowl here in front, and keeping your intentions in an affirmative manner, in that, not that you want to get rid of this and clear that and pray for this person or that person and whatever, but that the intention is the end result. What you want to see, what you want to experience, what you want to have manifest in your life. And that's the intention. So, and if you didn't write it in that manner, that's okay. Just reformulate it for yourself in your mind, you know, and when, you know, as we go through this. So anyhow, holographic sound is a different method of creating sound because it's a blending of sacred sound and geometry. And the geometries open the sound up into its multidimensional form. And in doing that, we're able to hit every level of consciousness. So it penetrates so much deeper than what we've experienced in, you know, in other aspects or other methods of using sound. So, and that's in a nutshell, one of the variances, the differences with holographic sound versus other sound healing practices. Anyhow, I teach this work, and I've been teaching it for over 23 years now. And I've got some trainings coming up. What do I have coming up? The next one is in Denver, middle of March, or latter part of March. And then beyond that, a level one, and I've set it up in two levels, level one and level two. And level one is also on coming up in May on Zoom. I'll be doing a level one on Zoom in May. And in May, June, July. Stuff going on all around. Best thing to do, go to the website, holographicsound.com, and you can see the calendar and see the things that are happening. I've got a four-day holographic sound healing training coming up in Dallas the first part of August. And from there, another one in Denver, and I'm planning one here in Austin, and it will probably be in May, June. It will probably be in June. So, and I'll let you know more about that. The next Monday meditation will be, this is March. It'll be in April, and it'll be on the 8th, on the solstice. I mean, the solstice. The equinox.
Total solar eclipse. Woo!
There's only so many more events I can go to on the eclipse that's occurring on the 8th. And So that'll be the next meditation that's coming up here. And what else? Egypt. If you're interested, have ever been interested in going to Egypt, I've been taking groups since, since 1999. And they're extraordinary experiences. And if you're drawn and feel guided to, check it out. It's amazing. I promise it will change your life. So anyway, I think I should probably just stop talking now and just get on to what we're here to do. So, the Egypt trip coming up is October 19th through November 2nd this year. Okay, it is hot in here, isn't it? Aisha, as soon as you get that set and going, will you go ask them to crank the air?
Yes.
That we're getting toasty in here. Thanks. Okay. I invite you to close your eyes. You know, never mind. I was gonna say, you know, my scatteredness with expressing things tonight. I originally was gonna touch on again, as I have multiple times before, the chaotic stuff that's going on right now. I mean, it's like rampant. And one of the things that we get to do when we're here and through experiences like this is move above that chaos. And that's where we want to stay. You know, not denying anything that's going on, but not having to dredge through it. You know, and just rise above it and ride that wave. So, anyway. And that's what we do through these experiences. So if you'll just close your eyes and let's get on that wave. And just begin to focus on your breathing. Focusing on the inhale and the exhale of your breath. And as you do, visualize or imagine a beautiful sphere of light around our room. Around the room. And through the center of this sphere is a shaft of golden light. Above, connected to the God source. Below, center of Mother Earth. as you look to the stream, you see there's a small boat. This boat has your name on it. Make your way to the boat and step in. Make yourself comfortable, for it is comfortable, and push on. As the stream picks up, the essence of the boat, as you begin floating downstream, making your way out to the center of the stream as the current becomes stronger, the stream becomes a gentle river, and as you look from side to side, you see experiences of your life, events, visions, some happy, some sad, those that no longer serve you begin to fade away as you find the gifts that present themselves. And as you continue downstream, seeing more and more of your life's experience, embracing the sad, the happy, expanding more and more as that is past is now past. It's only a memory, and that memory only has the power that you give it. So release that along with your intention. Just breathe. Thank you. Thank you. as it opens even more fully. To take in the blessing of the Gayatri Mantra. As you breathe, as the essence, the energy moves through, illuminating every cell in your body. In harmony, in balance, in wholeness. Filling with divine life force energy with every breath.
Om 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 Om
confirms this knowing, this truth. Every breath. Thank you. How's everybody doing? Okay. Is there anything that you would like to share of your experience? Or any questions, comments? Yes.
I consider myself fire and someone's water is really to me. But when I was on that boat and turned into the ocean, I started like dancing with the sun and the moon. And then I turned into water.
You did?
So I was like, ooh.
So you're a water girl. Before we continue on, I want to say thank you to everyone who has joined us online and in person. And just to let you know, everything that comes through, the sounds, the tones, everything, the nuances that occur, they're all about you. It's your essence and your energy that comes and creates this experience. So I want to thank each one of you for being present, for being here, and bringing your vibration, your essence, to create the symphony that we've created. So thank you. And blessings to everyone that's been streaming with us or that will stream with us. And just a reminder, we do the evening on a low donation basis. If you're streaming, there's a link in there where you can do a donation if you like. And with that, so long, and hope to see you in April. I got that right this time. I didn't have to count, you know. January, February.